Hello everybody, welcome to another episode of Basement Electronics. So today we're going to be looking at the FM RF amplifier, the mixer, and the oscillator, as well as the AFC stage of the radio. But first we have to build the mixer. So I'll be right back. Now the part we just soldered was the mixer stage. Now this stage is where the amplified radio waves are heterodyned or mixed with the local oscillator. During the mixing process, a difference frequency of 10.7 megahertz is produced. I'm reading this out of the book, by the way. This difference frequency is used as the intermediate frequency in FM radios. The collector of transistor Q3, right here, contains an intermediate frequency transformer, T1, is tuned only to the difference frequency. This transformer rejects all frequency except for those near 10.7 megahertz. Now, when you heterodyne a frequency, you usually end up with an addition frequency and a difference frequency because of the wave nature of the wave nature of waves. But you end up basically with a plus and a minus. This uses the plus part of that heterodyne in order to isolate the actual audio from the radio waves. The RF amplifier and the oscillator are the only two resonant circuits that change when the radio is tuned for different stations. Since a radio station may exist 10.7 megahertz above the oscillator frequency, it is important that the RF stage rejects the station, selects only the station 10.7 megahertz below the oscillator frequency. So that's the plus and minus. So you want to make sure that it only grabs the lower part of the frequency, not the upper part. The frequency of the undesired station, 10.7 megahertz above the oscillator, is called the image frequency. Since this FM receiver has an RF amplifier, the image frequency is reduced significantly. Resistor R9, where are you? Right here. R9 and capacitor C12, right here, decouple the voltage of the tuner from the voltage of the intermediate frequency stages. So this resistor and this capacitor are used to filter out the addition frequency from the oscillator. Meanwhile, we use the difference frequency in order to get our audio from the FM radio station. So for testing, the first thing we want to do is we want to know the voltage at the base of Q3, and they want 1.8 volts plus or minus 2 volts. Typically though, they'd like to see no more than 10% variance, so we'd like to try to see it within 0.2 volts, or I would like to see it within 0.2 volts. So we're gonna want this off TP13. Of course, this grounded off to 15. And that is 1.92 volts. So 0.12 volts off the 1.8, which is still within the limits. So I'm okay with that. Connector ground. Connector capacitor to TP13. The frequency is at 10.7 megahertz. Right now my amplitude is all the way down to 0 volts. Now we want to hook this onto TP12, which is right here. All right, so I learned a little trick since the last video. Well, little trick, I learned how to use the oscilloscope properly. So if you hit auto, hear the relays clicking away in there. It should find the wave. See, now we have our 20 millivolts peak to peak, but we want it at 40. So let's raise this 30, 40. Yeah. It's kind of, there we go. I'm happier with that. So now we want to adjust T1 for a peak. So just turning it up. I'm going to turn this down in order to try to maintain the 40 millivolts. Huh, that's at the stop. So that is now at 20 millivolts. So it should actually be at about 13 millivolts. Let me try that. So I'm still getting a pretty high gain here. Actually be a low gain because I'm getting essentially a gain of 1 instead of 3. That might have something to do with the fact that I'm at the stop and it wants to go further. So the question is, where did I mess up in there? Well, now if we do a bandwidth test, increase the amplitude to 40 volt meter volt V, increase the voltage to the voltage drops to 707 or frequency. So I am going to go to 10 kilohertz. So where are we? Increase the frequency until the voltage drops. There, call it that. So 11.03 is the high. And then the low, oops, wrong way. See, one of the problems, you'll notice that as I'm turning down the frequency, it's actually getting higher, which means we were never at the peak. Seem to be peaking out around 10.07 megahertz, which could be a problem. Well, we'll come back to that. There will probably be some fine-tuning afterwards, but I'm gonna solder the FM oscillator together and we will be right back. Alright, our FM oscillator has been built. So now we're going to do some tests on it and hope that they go better than they did last time. So first thing we need to do is check the bias on Q2 here. I got the voltage hooked up, so let's turn the power on. So we are looking for 4 volts on the base of Q2. So this, of course, is the oscillator. The oscillator, 3.73 volts, that's pretty good. The oscillator generates the frequency to a heterodyne with the with the input signal, the receive signal, so that we can filter out the carrier wave, and receive the radio station audio. Now, that is the only test that they want us to do for the oscillator. So the next piece we're doing is the AFC here. So before we put it together, there's only like 5 parts to solder in here. When the radio is tuned to a station, it will be desirable for the radio to lock on a station. Due to the changes in temperature, voltage, and other effects, the local oscillator may change its frequency of oscillation. If this occurs, the center frequency of 10.7 MHz will not be maintained. Automatic frequency control, AFC, is used to maintain the 10.7 MHz center frequency. When the local oscillator drifts, the radio detector will produce a DC correction voltage. The audio signal rides on this DC correction voltage. The signal is fed to a filter network which removes the audio so that a pure DC voltage is produced. This voltage is fed to a special diode called a varicitor. The diode is right there, D1. The varicitor will change its internal capacitance when a voltage is applied. The ratio detector diodes are positioned in such a way that when the 10.7 MHz center frequency increases, the DC correction voltage will decrease. Yeah. Likewise, when the 10.7 MHz center frequency decreases, the DC correction voltage will increase. This voltage change causes the capacitance of the varicitor to change. The varicitor is connected to the emitter of Q2 here. So any capacitance change in the varicitor is seen at the emitter of the oscillator. A change in capacitance at the emitter of Q2 will change the frequency of oscillation of the local oscillator. All right. So let's put it together and then hook it up. All right. So for this testing, we're not going to need the oscilloscope. We only need the function generator and my voltmeter. So first things first, what do we want here? Connect the RF generator. The circuit is shown in figure 50. Set your generator at 10.7 megahertz, no modulation, and moderate signal strength output. So let's say 1 volt. I don't know how moderate that is, but so let's hook up the oscilloscope. This goes on to, okay, so we want to add this to the base of Q3, which is right here, which has a convenient test pin on it. I should probably turn the power on the radio. Sure the camera can see that. Record the voltage of D1. So that is right. 7.31 volts. Slowly decrease the frequency of my generator. Oh. So frequency. First of all, frequency was wrong. 7.35 volts. That should be a bit of a clue for, let's say, decrease. Yeah. So decrease. And the voltage decreases. All right, 10.2 megahertz. This is now at 7.31. Watch your slowly decrease the frequency of your generator as the frequency decreases. Oh, the voltage should increase.
First of all, this has fallen off.
All right, let's reset this. So back to 10.7. I know it's hooked up this time. And ooh, that's a funky sound. 7.23, 2.24. So let's try this again. Slowly decrease the frequency of your generator. As the frequency decreases, the voltage D1 should increase. So, it's doing it this time. It's actually going up. So I started at 10.24 at 10.7 megahertz, and now at 9.0 megahertz, and it's at 7.35. So yeah, it went up 0.11 volts. So bring it back to, so now we want to increase it, and how much you want to bet that the volts are going to decrease? Oh wow, it's actually going down pretty quick. Oh. Well, that's interesting. All right, 10.7, rather 7.24 volts. Start going up. The voltage is going down. So we're at 11.2 and we're at 7.15 volts. What's interesting is you keep going, the voltage starts going back up again. Do they say that? While watching your VOM, increase the frequency generator. As the frequency increases, the voltage in D1 should decrease. This correction voltage is what keeps the oscillator from drifting. The voltage at D1 still does not change at D1 check, blah, blah, blah. If these please insert correctly and the voltage at D1 still doesn't change, increase the amplitude generator and repeat the steps again. All right, so, but that was interesting. If the frequency starts getting too high, the voltage starts going up again. So I'm going to turn this off. So this is actually a lot longer than I thought it was going to be. So we did the FM mixer and oscillator and the AFC. It was actually a good bit of work on this project. We still have the RF amplifier and the antenna to do. And there's going to be a lot of testing involved with that too, which I think is probably going to be enough to justify another video. So I'm going to finish this here. Thank you very much, everybody, for watching. I hope you found it interesting, if not informative. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.